in. No gunshots, but they get in.
Hey, what's up you guys? It's Craft Farms here, back again with another video. And today we're going to be back on Dad's farm. This is your Saturday video. By the time you're watching this, I am in Idaho. And I'm probably getting ready for the wedding. Today is Tuesday. It is just about 7 o'clock at night. We're just about done with the beans. We got 4 more passes left. So I figured I should start recording right now. Today you had 2 videos out. You had a farm update that many people have been requesting. Then also the previous episode of this map. Thursday you had a video of me working on my new mod project, a Dodge Ram 3500 Cummins. Dually, if you haven't already checked that video out, make sure to go check it out. It's about an hour long, so you might have to do some skipping in it and whatnot, but maybe you can learn something from it or something. So we're still rocking along with the beans. This field is also doing very, very well, as did field 15. We have... What do we got? 9 bins full? 10? Something like that? Let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep, we have 10 bins full, and we're working on the 11th of soybeans only. It's been quite the interesting thing. I will show you one of the screenshots here. As you can tell from this screenshot, that bin there was quite the thing to get into. The truck was basically in the corner here. Pretty tight to get into there. And it is actually pretty fairly tight to get into this bin as well. It's not quite that terrible, but you do have to start cranking so that you don't hit the fence here. Definitely not excited to fill the bins along here. Maybe what I'll do, let's move these things backwards in a ways, so right about there. Perfect, that'll work. I know this is not at all a realistic way to move your bins, but it's what I'm doing, so we'll just kind of move a few of these back for now. Or maybe all of them, I guess. Just to put them a little bit further back. So that way we can get into them a little better with the auger and the truck. So yeah, right after I finished recording the toy farm update, I went ahead and ordered the items that I showed in the video that I said I would buy. 2 new semis and hopper trailers, DCP trucks to be exact. And we only have 3 bins left to move, so we're just about done. Okay. Now we gotta get back to moving these. I probably could have moved this one back as well, but I'll do that after we finish filling it. Or else maybe I'll do it before and then just move the auger once we are done moving these. And then I also bought a new combine and two new grain carts. And then I, after that video, sat and took pictures of the things and posted them for sale. So, as of today, Tuesday, if I can get my mind on the right track. As of today, I haven't gotten any bites on them. It's only been a couple of hours, and that's not what I wanted to do. It's only been a couple of hours that they've been up, about three or four, something like that. So, not expecting anything quite yet. Oh, that's right, you can't turn these. Forgot about that. Okay, so now let's readjust the auger here. So it is getting dark out again. We're at 7 o'clock at night. So actually the time in-game isn't too far off from real life. Oh, that's way too low. So yeah, I'm not sure when I'm coming back from Idaho. So if you don't have a video on Tuesday, I'm not home yet, obviously, so... So yeah, you just won't have a video for Tuesday, otherwise I have made it back, like Sunday or Monday. I think we're coming back maybe Monday. Something like that. It's a 13-hour drive to get there. And, so, I know tomorrow my dad's picking me up. Tomorrow being Wednesday. He's picking me up after he gets off work. And then we're actually leaving early Thursday morning. The original plan was that we were going to leave. I think my dad said we were going to, like, leave after him and my stepmom got off of work on Thursday. Or after my stepmom got off of work on Thursday. And so he would sleep all day Thursday, and then he would drive all night Thursday night. That way my baby sister could sleep, you know, keep her normal sleep schedule and whatever. But now they decided to leave early in the morning. Which is fine as well. We'll get there both ways, so... So we'll go ahead and get filled up here. So once we finish combining field 16 here, we're going to take the combine back into the farm, and we're going to put the header on the header trailer. And, well, we're going to wash the header first, and then put it, we're just going to put it in the yard. We're not going to put it back on the header trailer, I think. We'll just set it in the yard somewhere, and then hook up to the corn head and get started on corn. And then we'll also fuel up everything. We have to fuel the combine before we head to the farm because it is low on fuel. Hopefully it has enough fuel to finish combining. I'll wait until Courseplay tells me that it needs to be refueled rather than should be refueled. But we should have enough fuel to make it for a little while. The should be fueled soon thing has been on for quite a while. So we've been making it work so far. Excuse me. Yeah, we have 72 liters, so we still have quite a bit. And then once we get to the farm here, show you guys how much grain we have at the moment. We're going to turn on, no we're not. Going to leave the truck lights off. So I think we might just fast forward time to the next day for the corn harvest. Just that way we're not combining in the dark. Because in the dark, my game lags quite a bit because of the lights. Or well, I shouldn't say quite a bit, but it doesn't run as smooth as it does in the daytime. So I went through earlier, while I was sitting here waiting for the combine to fill, I went through the shop and looked at all the stuff that I want to buy after we sell off all of our grain and added up the prices. Not just of cattle equipment, but, you know, like new semis, new fertilizer setups, new grain trailers, all that good stuff. And it's just about $2 million in equipment. So we need to make a lot from our grain. And we're also, you know, because, like, we're going to be buying a different combine and headers. So, you know, the combine we have and the headers we have and header trailer we have now, those will all get sold. And the grain cart tractor we have right now will get sold, and we'll be buying a new one. And, you know, trucks, tractors, implements, all that stuff will, you know, stuff will be getting replaced. So we'll also be making money from it by selling it. Which we will be selling it directly rather than, you know, just going through the store menu. We will be taking it to the shop and selling it that way, getting the most bang for our buck. And get the absolute most money that we can off of it. So we should have one more trip to make with the truck. It probably won't be full, I'm going to guess, because we don't have a whole lot left. So we'll maybe have, we'll have one full trailer and then a partial trailer, because it takes two grain cart loads and a combine load to fill up the truck completely, fill both trailers. So we got, this will be one grain cart load here once it fills, and then we'll maybe have maybe one more grain cart, we'll see. We only have a little bit left. We have two full passes and then a partial pass, so we should be okay. And our bin is at 61%, so shouldn't have to do another bin, I wouldn't think. I hope not. If we do, then we'll just truck it to the elevator. Because there's no point, that I know there will not be much grain left, so that wouldn't pay to go dump it in another bin, because it would just be a waste of bin. So let's look here, we have, so we have 2.5 million liters of beans so far. That's what I wanted to hit, not that. I accidentally hit 8 rather than X for whatever stupid reason. Alright, so we gotta crank it here and avoid the fence. We can actually back up a little bit. Get that front hopper over the jump auger. Yeah, we should have enough fuel to make it. We've only used 4 liters in the bit that since we last looked, so we'll have plenty enough to finish this field, but we'll definitely have to fill it up before we head back to the farm and get the corn header. Might fill this bin. It depends on how much more grain we get, but it'll be up there a ways. And it's kind of funny, I noticed they didn't set the fill plane to go all the way up to the top, but I guess normally you don't fill your bins completely up to the top. But would have given you maybe, I don't know, maybe another 5,000 to 10,000 or something. Maybe not even that much. Ah, come on. There it goes. So yeah, once harvest is over, so we have, I guess, let me start with this first. So, in this video, we'll start on corn harvest. On Tuesday's video, we'll be working on corn harvest. And then on next Thursday's video, we will be finishing corn harvest. So, we have two more days, I guess I'll say. Two more days of harvest to do. And then after that, in Thursday's video, we'll be taking all the equipment to the yard and washing everything except for the truck and trailers off. Now, the reason that we won't be washing the truck and trailers is because right away, once we finish washing the rest of the equipment and get it put away, we're going to sit and fast forward time until we get a great demand for wheat, corn, or soybeans, or else if there's a really good price, you know, like if we look right now, soybean is $1,574. So, you know, if we sell it at that, that'd be okay. But like wheat and corn, we'll sit and wait for a great demand and sell it then. And get the most money that we possibly can. Might do it for the soybeans too. And just sell as much as we can during the great demand. But we'll see what happens, I guess. We shall find out when that time comes. So let's go over here and get the grain cart unloaded so that way we can get back to emptying the combine. So as you can see, I moved the Chevy and my fuel trailer over here, just to have over here for the time. And I think what we're actually going to do is we're going to pull this up by that farm up there, because that's where the combine's going to end. The ending point, or the stop point, is up by that farm up there. So we will head on over here and park the truck up here so that way we can fill up the combine right away. Had a little bit of damage on our truck here. So let's kind of park it on this driveway here. Not so that we're blocking it, and we don't want to make the neighbors mad, but just kind of right over here. So that way we're up here, but we're not in the neighbor's way. So I've had a couple people asking me how my map is going, and tell you guys the truth, I have not touched the map in a while. I've been working on other projects, playing Farm Sim, doing other stuff. That, and I had an issue with my building here. I have it fixed now, but I'll kind of explain what the deal was. Come on, Blender, load up. So you can see here, this is the elevator Quonset. I need to do some adjustments on my doors here. They're not straight at all. I need to fix those. But this is the elevator Quonset. Now, it's pretty crazy when you go into here. There's a lot of pieces on it. But when I would export it to Giant's Editor, you would see the front and then a very tiny little bit of the inside, and that was it. And I could not figure out, you know, you can see it fully in Blender here, but you can't see it in Giant's editor. So I asked a buddy of mine, and he said you have to add the solidify modifier to it, which you can see makes it a lot thicker. Let's just go right here and I'll show you guys. So without and with makes it a lot thicker. And then you just go in and you add your edge split modifier to it. And there you go. See, that didn't make a huge difference, but I always apply it anyways. So now I just need to make up the doors and then learn how to get my doors exported to to Giant's editor and be able to have them working. So yeah, I need to figure that out. That's the next task eventually. Once I finish the Dodge anyways, that's when I'll try and do that. Yeah, this combine is definitely a fuel hog. Definitely a fuel hog. So we might empty on the grain cart once, maybe twice more. We'll see. Well, obviously we'll dump on it at least twice. We'll dump on it once here in the field and then a second time to empty the combine. Okay, get out of the way, grain cart. Alright, combine, you're good to go. Let's go. You don't have to wait for him to stop. You can go. Alright, whatever. Well, maybe we won't need to come back. Ah, yeah, we do. I was gonna say, we can just pick it up, but we're not. We're leaving two rows and that is not going to happen. Two rows is too many. I'd be okay with leaving like little bits and pieces of one row, but no way am I leaving two full rows to be exact, even. Or to be precise, whatever you want to say. Got a little bit of weed infestation there. So here's our corn. I know I showed it in the last video, but it's looking pretty good. Got a little bit of acidity. We could use some rain. I don't know. It's not supposed to rain till Sunday. Oh wait, no, that's not rain. That's snow. So we need to get the crop off. What is today? Today is Thursday. So in game anyways. So we have a few days to get the crop off, which we only need one day, so. So yeah, once we can afford haying equipment, we will have a lot of hay or grass that we can cut, because I will basically cut nearly every single bit of grass on the map. Around the fields, in between the fields, over in there, down in there, down in there, just everywhere I possibly can to get as much hay as possible, so that way we won't have to do hay for quite a while. We don't have to focus on hay, because we have quite a few straw bales, so we need quite a few hay bales. And we got a lot of silage, so if we can stockpile all that stuff and not have to do any of that for quite a while, that would be very, very nice. So we will take over here to finish the last little bit. finish unloading here, and we'll have about one grain cart full. So what we're going to do, we're going to whip around here, and then bring that in, and wait for that guy to quit being our driver, I guess I'll say. So that way we can request him and just have him follow us to the end of the field. If he's going to. Doesn't look like he will. Alrighty then. Might just have to stop him and bring him up here then. So we'll finish combining here. And then we also need to figure out how much crop we had. Let's see, our bin is helpful. 86. It's going to be pretty close. Hopefully we don't fill the bin. Because if we do, that's really going to be annoying. Because we won't have all that much grain left, and we'll have to haul all the way over to the elevator. Which I guess it wouldn't be too far out of our way. We could just go to like ConAgra and dump it there, and then we can be right at field 5 to start combining corn. So I guess it won't be too terrible if that ends up happening. I do still need to go back and edit the map to add the lime triggers to it. I will probably go and do that very soon. What I might do is just remove one of the triggers at the crop production services and replace it with the lime trigger. That's probably what I'll do. Let me turn off our lights here. Don't need them. Stop this guy and shut off the lights here too. And we'll head on up here to the combine. And then we'll unload the last little bit. And then I don't know what I want to do. Do I want to just take the grain cart to the farm? Could just as well, then we don't even have to move the truck right now. We can just set the grain cart to follow the combine. That would work. Now we need to fuel this guy up and repair him. So that way he is fully repaired for when we start on corn. Oops, wrong button. Alright, so we'll go over here and get fueled up. I'm on the wrong side, aren't I? Yes, I am. Figures. Give the combine a drink. There we go. So we'll let him fill. We're gonna fold the combine, fold the header. And you know what? We will just we can just pull this guy up here as well. That's what we can do. Pull him up behind here. Get him fueling up as well. We'll hop in this guy and get our tractor, grain carts. Both are repaired. Oh, our truck is actually already in the field. That's right. Jeez. So we'll just take this up to the grain cart. Man, we might fill the bin. I guess I wouldn't complain if we did. It'd be all the more grain, but that's kind of a nuisance to get out or to get back to starting on corn. Or get to starting on corn, not get back to. I took that really sharp and fast. That was not planned. Our equipment is still filling fuel. We'll just pull it right up to where the green cart is, just like this. And top off. Oops. Helps if I'm in the right thing. Boy, the grain cart holds a lot of, or the grain cart tractor holds a lot of fuel. Okay, so we'll move this guy out onto the road here. And we'll also just set our semi up to be on follow me mod as well. It'll definitely be nice when we do corn to have the correct fill plane and unload texture on this grain cart. Since it doesn't have multi-fruit added to it. The trailer seems to, though. That definitely is not wheat, I don't think. Otherwise, that's really a cool wheat texture. So our grain cart's just about empty. And yeah, I'm pretty sure we're gonna fill our bin. I guess we should be in the grain cart because we want that. Well, the grain cart doesn't even have to go. I'm losing it. We'll just shut that off for now. All right. Let's head to the farm. Let's quick snap a screenshot first. Oops. Turn our beacons and hazards back on. Ah, I can't go in cab on this combine. It just drives me nuts. I hate it. Alright, so we gotta make sure that we take this wide for the truck. But not too wide that we hit the telephone pole. Because that would not be fun at all. Ah. I could have gone a little wider, but oh well. It does not matter. Whew. I think I cut that a little too close there. Oof. That was a close one. That was really close.
Wow.
That was my bad. See, we're not going to wash off the combine. We're just going to leave it dirty. Yep, we are going to hit the header trailer. I was hoping that I wouldn't, but evidently the header said otherwise. We'll just stop our truck right there. And we will take this up to the pressure washer and get the header cleaned up and put away, and we will switch over to the corn header. Now we'll get this thing unhooked from the combine. We'll put it back behind the shop here. And I think we can actually just sell our header trailer because don't really need it. But we'll do that later on. I need to shut that door again. I had to go into that shop for to look at something once and forgot to shut it. Shut the door on it, so. Alright, so we will put this into the combine section. And then we need to get the header unfolded. Once the course moves. There we go. Need to unfold this. Alright, so we need 5 first. And we're going to start in the north. Sorry about that. Northeast. And head south with 2 headlands. And. Alright. 12.2 it hits. F5 combine corn. Alright, field 6 we want in the northwest, heading south. F6 combine corn. And we want that to start in northeast as well. Yeah, and head south with 3 headlands just because of that farm there. F7 combine corn. And then finally field 8, which is also going to be in the northeast. So all we need to do is change this to 8 and that down to 2. Field 8, combine corn. There we go. Alright, so we can get rid of that. And we can fold our corn head back up. And we're going to load field 5 up. This grain cart course can go there. Need field 5. Alright, so we will get this guy started on combining, or just to the field anyways, and then we will get the truck unloaded, and then we'll get started on corn. We won't do much because I don't want to make this video too much longer, otherwise I'll be sitting here that much longer to work on it, to get it uploaded and scheduled. So we will just cruise on over to field 5 here. So yeah, then after harvest, there will be a lot of soil management going on. Because I'm sure that the soil will be probably pretty terrible from sitting for a few days, I'm guessing that it'll be. That, you know, if we drive up here, let's see what this field's like right now. It's actually not too terrible. But it will need to be better. Alright, so let's get corn head unfolded, get the combine unfolded. Actually, just the combine for now. Wait with the header until we're just a little bit closer. And our animated chopper is still going. Don't need that going right now. Alright, now we'll unfold the header, get this guy up over here. Now we'll hop onto the truck, and let's get this thing unloaded. So I think what I'll do is I'll start combining corn here in this video in the night, and then I'll just fast forward time after this video to the next day. To combine in the daytime. So we're going to unload the back trailer first, since that one is not very full. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Shoot. Now I just totally screwed up. Alright, so let's see, this bin will be full, and the reason I'm unloading the back trailer is because it's not full, and then the front trailer, rather than like emptying the front trailer or something, and having just a little bit in the back trailer, I'd rather just have a front trailer to worry about. Yeah, we only have 9% left in the bin, so definitely will be filling it. And when we do fill it, we'll just take the auger and put it over top of the trailer and empty out whatever is in the auger that doesn't need to be. Alright, so we'll get backed up here so we can unload the front trailer. We'll make a little bit of money then. Won't be a whole lot, but it'll be a little bit of money. We'll just tarp our rear trailer. That way when we go to empty our auger, we don't accidentally dump into the rear trailer and completely ruin my whole idea. My whole plan, I should say. Alright, so now to figure out how I'm going to do this. I just go like this, and then we'll back the truck up. Go. Let's back this truck up a little bit. There we go. Get the auger unloaded. Just like that. Alright, so now what we need to do is figure out. We have 250,000 times 11 equals plus 31,741 equals So we have 2,781,741 liters of soybeans. So let's go ahead, put that down in the document here. There we go. So total of liters. Two seven eight one seven four one. Perfect. Now let's copy this and go. Oops. Hectares to acre. No. Liters to bushels. That's what I want, not that. I don't want the whole thing. I just want the 0.1. Alright. So we'll just... 78,939.1. 78,939.1. So if we go 78,939.1 divided by 279.3, 282.6. Again, bushels per acre is not at all realistic. Yes, I know. It's farm sim. I know that it's not realistic. Although 200 bushel corn, I have been hearing people having that. So, all right, yeah, we are done with beans. So we'll just run on over to the elevator here and sell this last little bit of beans and then get started on corn. And we'll get started on combining. And we'll just ride around with the combine until he fills up. And if it fills very fast, then we'll set up course play for the grain cart before I end the video. Otherwise, if it fills pretty slow, we'll ride around with it a little bit and then I'll end the video. Because I am not sure what the beans or what the corn is going to yield. Hopefully, it's pretty good. We'll just head on up here to ConAgra and unload this and come back. Well, the truck is going to be on that side of the field anyways, so we won't have to go too far out of our way. And it's going to be on the other side of the road in the grass area. How in the world are we going to go through here? Let's see. Is there, I don't know if this is a sell point up here or not, too. Oh, this is terminal. Let's see. Where are beans taken? ADM. Crap. We're not even in the right place. We got to go to a whole other area. Pretty sure. It's just... Whoa! I have no idea what just happened there. But evidently, the... pup trailer did not at all like going over that. Wow, 54% damage. Holy crap, that was not good. Okay, so we now have to go to ADM, which is out of the way. Yeah, this video is going to end up being longer, but oh well. Sometimes the half hour just isn't long enough to do all of what you want to do. I know that happens quite a lot. Especially when you're setting up a new field. You got You know, it takes time to set up your truck, set up your grain cart, set up your combine, and set up the auger. So that just like kills time, a lot of time, and then you end up not having all that much time to do what you intended on doing. Kind of sucks that this is the only place that you can go to, but oh well. Can't have it all convenient in one spot, so. Ooh, that was close. Alright, so we will head on in here and sell this. Screenshot. Alright. So we made it about $12,000 off of that. We were at $408,000 in the hole, and now we are $356,000. Oh, wait, no. We're making way more than 12. Jeez. I don't know what I was thinking. That was a lot more than 12. That was like 52,000, what that would have been. Okay, let's just pull the truck off on the side here and get started on corn. I'm sure you guys are probably getting sick of me just wasting time doing other stuff. Although I'm really not wasting time on purpose, it's just taking time. And from the looks of it, this is going to be some pretty good corn. Very good corn. Holy smokes. Let's get ahead of the combine here. Yeah, this is really going to be good corn. That is good. That is good. So, I think we'll just close off the video now. Just because it's been getting a little long. I don't want it to be too terribly long. So, thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure that you hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Make sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Make sure to check out, turn on my post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central Time and Saturdays at noon Central. Check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.